Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Colonial Downs here on Friday. It is August the 30th, 2019. Gonna look the fourth race from Colonial, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world, and join me tomorrow for my Woodward preview from Saratoga, and locally join me for my Virginia Derby preview video from Colonial. And also, if you like harness racing, great harness racing tomorrow from Yonkers with the Yonkers Trot and the Canadian Pacing Derby from Mohawk. So join me for that. But let's get to the fourth race from Colonial, which is a very good race, and it's on dirt, which is very rare for Colonial. But the fourth race, it's Lounge Optional Claimer per $60,000. Race for 3-year-olds and upwards, which never started for a claim price won a claim price of $25,000, blah, 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 blah. We all know the conditions. Do I really have to read it? But we have a field here. Field of 7 horses going to the main dirt course, distance of ground of 1,400 meters, or the 7 furlong trip on that dirt course, 1,400, 7 furlongs, and I show the diagram, it just gives me that little extra second to look down, but no, just bear with me. Top selection, I'm going to take the number 2 horse, he's no bull, I'm going to go 2-5-3-1 in the superfecta, 2-5-3-1 super, top selection 2 horse, he's no bull, this 3-year-old gelding by Haynes Field, Thomas Vance trained, CC Lopez, the veteran, gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came the 8th of August at Colonial, 1 mile an hour, 25 claimer, and the horse finished 4th by 3.5 lengths. The horse stalked early on. He never got that good turn of foot, but he didn't run half bad, but he still could improve a lot more. Before that, he ran a good race and claiming 30 at Ellis, 7 furlongs, July 12th. The horse won by a neck, almost on the lead all throughout. He was shortening stride late, but he still got the job done. I thought it was a good run there, and then against a lot tougher competition at Churchill, 7 furlongs, June 28th, and claiming 20. The horse finished 2nd by 2.5 lengths there. It was a step down. Well, it was claiming 20, then he ran a claiming 30, but I thought it was a tougher race there, that claiming 20. But he stalked early on. He had the lead. He got caught, but he still ran a good race. But he had a lot, you know, he had a lot of issues that day. Not his fault, particularly. Go watch the replay if you don't believe me. And then before then, claiming 20 at Churchill, mile 16th. He's not a router. He finished 3rd by 3 lengths, and he kind of hit the wall on the straightaway. Go back to the replay. Can't show replays, copyright issues. But and then before they went claiming 16 at Churchill, going 6 furlongs, and the horse finished 5th by 7 lengths, and the horse just had nothing. Set the pace early on, but then after that had nothing. The 1-2-3 out of that race also won next start out. But coming here to the 7 furlong trip, a step down class from the last few, and 9-2. I think I'll run well, so I'll take him. So to recap my selection for the 4th from Colonial, let's take the 2 horse. He's in a bowl. We'll go 2-5-3-1 in the superfecta. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.